We got two drivers in there.
He's a veteran, but some might call this night Captain Ronald Johnson's first night on the job.
So far, it's been really tame.
Hope it'll stay that way.
Hope it'll stay that way. The crowd is actually imagining itself.
Missouri's governor announced going forward the state's highway patrol will be heading up security. That makes Johnson the man in charge of keeping order in a city that has seen five nights of violent clashes between demonstrators and police.
Don't expect any issues, but just in case there are some issues where we some parties that may get unruly and we need to get out.
Captain Johnson took our crew with him on one of his first assignments.
And also, I want to get down here and kind of get an assessment of what the mood is and if there's anything we need to do different. I think we have to continue to assess it and monitor it and go from there. We're actually going to walk in the center.
We're going to walk in the center.
No, we're going to walk on the side.
All right, we'll walk on the side.
Anytime they see a county officer, they project an anger on them if they're acting out. You know, so what I'm saying is we've been in the crowd talking and mingling and haven't had any issues.
Right. This is what I'm going to do. I'm just going to take a chance. I'm going to have you guys turn around and go back to the McDonald's, both of you, and then I'll call you when I need you.
And then came time to meet the demonstrator.
I'm so proud of you. Appreciate you, sir.
No tear gas, no riot gear. Instead, call it street diplomacy.
How you doing, baby?
Man, hey, you gonna get this together?
And we're gonna try. We're gonna try to get it together.
He's from protest. We love info.
So is this the type of reception you expected to receive when you came down here?
This is, yes.
And while there were plenty of hugs and handshakes, there were tough questions, too.
Come on.
Actually, they're not allowed to leave the scene. They took them back for questioning. That's normal. You know what? And I'm tired too, and we're gonna get it right.
Get down here. Come visit us down here.
I've lived here 42 years.
Thank you.
I've lived here 42 years. I do visit this neighborhood. My mama lived right around the corner.
So what do you make of all of this crowd, all of these people around you, surrounding you like this in this way, supporting it?
Their voice is being heard, and I think that's all that's bottom line is that's what they want, their voice to be heard.
Did you expect this kind of reception? Because certainly police were not getting this kind of reception before.
Not to this magnitude. Well, I know it's good people that live in this community, and I've lived in here 48 years of my life, and so I know we've got good people in this community.
Johnson says his approach is and has always been an honest one.
I just found this out a few hours ago that I was going to be in this job. If I'm not back tonight, I'll be back tomorrow.
Back up, y'all.
And that's a promise. I'm coming back.
You sure?
The name.
Don't be lying. I'm going to be looking for you.
You have a towel for me.
We need you.
A lot of old pain, a lot of old wounds, a lot of things to address that go beyond this incident here. It's going to take some time to address those issues, far beyond today, far beyond what's happened here.
Do you feel an overwhelming sense of pressure to take all of this on?
No, because I don't think there's pressure, to be honest. And I think if we treat them with respect and honesty, that's all that we can do.
And when the night was over, finally time to reflect.
I believe there has been a shift. I think we're starting making some gains and some trust. And it's obvious, walking through the crowd and riding up just a second ago, that everybody has not bought into that trust.
And Johnson says building that kind of trust will take time. Jason Carroll, CNN, Ferguson, Missouri.